every Sunday we light the Christ candle, and I'm going to ask Jakaya to come and to share that with us. Thank you, Jakaya. And now Todd Beck is going to bring forth our prayer box, and as you know, every time you enter on Sunday, there's an opportunity for you to write down your prayer request. We pray over this prayer box, the contents of this prayer box, every Tuesday at our Tuesday prayer service. And after a while, we send them all to Silent Unity, where they're praying there for an additional 30 days. Thank you, Todd. And thank you, Jakai.
Good morning, everyone. So now we're going to all stand and greet your neighbor, but we're going to do something a little different this morning, okay? So playing with the youth theme, we're going to turn to our neighbor and tell them who you want to be when you grow up.
There is one presence, one power, one love active in my life, serving in this ministry, sacred in all people everywhere, enlightening our world today, God the good.
You may be seated.
Amen. This next song is called Sanctuary. This is a song that we sing at every rally that we go to, whether it's Summer Connection, spring, or fall. The way they're standing, arm in arm, that's how we do it together. So they're going to demonstrate the first time through the verse, and then on the second time, we're going to sing it again, and I want all of you to join them together and stand up and do the same thing as they're doing. Got it?
Yes, I
do. All right. Ready?
Imagine you're walking through a meadow. You see many different colors here. Roses, tiger lilies, and daisies, and lavenders. Suddenly, a tree catches your attention. You walk towards it. But just as you're going to grab a branch to climb up, you fall through a big hole. This hole is miles deep, and you feel like you've been falling for hours. When you land, you find yourself surrounded by people. They start telling you what you are supposed to be. Then, you remember that this is your dream. You control what happens. You create the beautiful things that wander in it. And you make these people disappear. You know who you are. No one can choose your destiny. You choose your own. You can be whatever you want to be. You can do whatever feels right for you. Then, you get the feeling of flying with the birds and the elementals. And you start to rise up into the air. You can see for miles in every direction. This is proof of what you can do. This proves that whatever you want to do, you can do. The people who surrounded you before come back, and they tell you that you can't do things your own way, that you do things their way. And then you say, I can be whoever and do whatever I want. You can't tell me what to be or what to do. In that instant, the people who surrounded you vaporize, along with all your fears and doubts. Now, take this feeling into the silence. Now, take three deep breaths and slowly let them out. Now, slowly move your hands and feet and open your eyes. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, of course, we just chose this clip for its good message. present in our second teachable moment. Here, Alice goes down the rabbit hole, I like to say, in pure, complete wonder. And so she's just floating down there. She says to her cat, "Bye, see you later." If I were flying, it'd probably be a different story, but I like to say she's going down in this love-based state rather than a fear-based state. And so that really teaches us something and makes us go, wow, we can choose to approach our lives with wonder and trust. So when someone asks, "Who are you?" I like to say, "I am filled with wonder and trust." And so can we all affirm that together? I am filled with wonder and trust. Thank you. Our third teachable moment is further in the movie, and it has to do with life journeys. So in the story, Alice is well into her journey, and she's running into some obstacles. How many of you have ever run into some obstacles? Yeah. And so here's an encounter she has with some talking flowers. And so you can remember in the beginning when she was singing her song, she was like, "In my world, all the flowers would talk to me, and it would be a grand old time." And so it starts out like that, but here you can see now the flowers are starting to figure out that she's not a flower herself. Now what can we learn from this? I look at it like, in the journey of life, there can be some people who may try to tell you who you are and what you should do. But Alice shows us here, you don't have to listen. Even if you get knocked down, you don't have to listen to them. You can make a joke about their manners. So for our third teachable moment, you can ask yourself who you are and say, "I am my own unique individual." Let's all say that together. I am my own individual. Perfect. Now, for our final teachable moment, we're going to talk more about Alice's journey, and this is the most important one. It's through a conversation she has with the crazy Cheshire cat. But pay attention to what the cat says, because he turns out not to be so crazy after all.
"Can you stand on your head?"
Right. So there's a very important line in there. It's key to understand. While on her journey, Alice comes across this cat, and she says, "Oh, hello, could you tell me which path I should take?" And what the cat says is key. He says, "Well, that depends on where you want to get to." And Alice doesn't really know how to respond. She says, "Oh, well, it really doesn't matter." And the cat says, "Well, then it really doesn't matter which way you go." So we can learn a lot from this. I like to think about it like, if you don't have a vision for your life or where you want to get to, you're really just letting life happen to you. But the beautiful thing about humans is that we have the power to choose whether we take an active or a passive approach to life. So, and we have the power to have a vision for our lives. So, how can we affirm this when asked who we really are? We can say, "I am a visionary in my own life journey." Can we say that all together? I am a visionary in my own life journey. Awesome. So that was our final teachable moment, but I would like to sum up all four of them for you just so you can remember them throughout your week and think about them on your own life journeys. So the first one was, "I am a powerful co-creator." The second was, "I am filled with wonder and trust." The third, "I am my own unique individual." And four, "I am a visionary in my own life journey." So those are some deep points to learn from Alice in Wonderland, huh? Anyway, so that was the end of our lesson, and now we're going to transition into our activity period. And we're going to have Jakaya and Katie help me demonstrate what this is going to look like, because you guys will be doing the same thing amongst yourselves.
Knock, knock. Who's there?
You.
Who are you?
I am a powerful co-creator.
Thank you very much. So what's going to happen is I would like you all to turn to your neighbor and discuss who you truly are. And that doesn't have to be what your job is or where you live. It should be what drives you and why you do what you do. And then we're going to have our lovely teens come around, and if you feel like sharing, you can. So, but take a few minutes to discuss who you truly are right now.
Crisis. And the crisis most of my life has been an identity crisis. I keep forgetting. one of the reasons I come to church is because church reminds me of that which I have forgotten. And that's why I come here. Because it reminds me that I'm divine, even though I may not always behave myself and make some poor choices and fall into some old habits of thinking the wrong kind of thoughts, I am reminded here that I am a child of God, that my nature is divine. You know, Jesus got in trouble. In Matthew's Gospel, chapter 10, the Jewish people, the rabbis, are approaching him because he is claiming that he is divine. And that's heresy for them, which means that they can stone him. But he reminds them, he says, "Is it not written in your law that ye are gods?" So the very nature of Jesus said that if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. The Father and I are one. He was so closely aligned with his divine nature that he inspires us to follow him. And that's what we do in Unity. Jesus is our way shore, coming to remind us that we are divine. We're made in the image and the likeness of God. Sort of like someone trying to find, like a fish trying to find out where the ocean is, or they're swimming in the ocean. And the scripture says we live and move and have our being within this God stuff. So that's why it's hard time sometimes for us to really grasp it, because we're in it all the time. In the Gospel of Thomas, it says, "If you will call forth that which is within you, it will bless you. If you fail to call forth that which is within you, it will destroy you." So we're talking about calling forth the Christ consciousness, that divine nature. Rumi said, "I looked in temples and in churches and in mosques, but I found the divine within my heart." That's what the journey is, to our heart and to our home. God bless you. I think Katie is due up next. Miss Katie. All right.
Divine Spirit, you are the source.
Are
likes funk? Because we're going to bring the funk back. So we invite you guys to sing along. If you feel like getting up and dancing, do it. Because we're going to have fun with this. So thank you.
This one for the blue girls and go-go girls, straight past you, smiling, wild.
our YOU chapters, and we are, I know that every one of us now is closer to the truth of our being, and maybe closer to the teenager in us, too. I want to especially thank Lisa Gusty and Emily Randolo, our YOU sponsors. Rehearsal, sleepover, breakfast, getting these kids up and up here. And it's just amazing what they have done. And that their commitment every Sunday to be in the YOU room with the children, with the teens, leading them along their spiritual journey. So I thank you both so much for all that you do. It's beyond measure. At this time, I also want to express gratitude to those of you who adopted our YOU angels this month. It helps support them as they go to camp and rallies, and it also was a way for us to get to know one another better and to connect our families. So it was a wonderful experience. If you are one of our wonderful adopters, would you please stand at this time? Our angels would like to join you and enjoy our scrapbook together. So angels, please stand.
Just like sitting around a campfire. You ready?
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be, with God as creator. Brothers and sisters, are we. Let us walk with each other.
Have an amazing week this weekend in Nashville.